Hey, superhero fans, how's it going? Are you still reeling from the events of this year's Avengers Infinity War when Thanos erased half of all life in the Marvel Cinematic Universe? Well, you're not the only ones. So are the heroes of the MCU, not least the God of Thunder himself. When Thor comes to terms with what's happened in the MCU, he's going to unleash hell on the Mad Titan. That you can guarantee. And it could come in the form of an army that he recruits. In this video, we'll look into the theory that Thor is set to recruit a vengeful horde to take Thanos down in Avengers 4. In the name of Odin the Allfather, don't forget to hit that subscribe button! It's the best way of keeping up to date with all of Screen Rant's great new videos. What Thanos did in Avengers Infinity War hit everyone extremely hard. And by everyone, we mean both the fans of the Marvel Cinematic Universe and, obviously, the characters who star in it. But one character was undoubtedly hit harder than most. Chris Hemsworth's Thor has been alive for more than 1,000 years. But what he bore witness to in Infinity War was worse than any atrocity he'd ever seen in his entire life. When Thanos enacted his plan to gather the Infinity Stones to snap his fingers and erase half of all life in the universe, not only did several of Thor's allies die in the resulting cull, the Mad Titan also murdered some of the people closest to the God of Thunder before the snap occurred. All in all, Thor had to watch Thanos slaughter the majority of Asgard's remaining civilians, kill his best friend Heimdall in cold blood by stabbing him through the chest, and murder his adoptive brother Loki by choking the life out of him. He later found out Thanos had killed the vast majority of Asgard's allies, the dwarves of Nidavellir, then had to look on helplessly as several of his fellow heroes, the likes of Groot, Scarlet Witch, Vision, and Falcon, were killed in the Battle of Wakanda, as a result of either Thanos' brutality or ultimately the infamous finger snap. Of course, there's also the fact Thanos attempted to kill Thor himself, and that won't have sat well with the Asgardian. All of that came after a number of other tragic and unfortunate events Thor had endured in recent years. The destruction of Asgard, a brief enslavement on Sakaar, the destruction of Mjolnir, the death of his father, the murder of his mother, banishment from Asgard, and the stripping of his powers, and more. The guy's had it rough recently. Moreover, Thor's been aware Thanos has been using him and his fellow heroes as pawns in the intricate game he's been playing for years prior to the events of Infinity War. The Mad Titan really does have a lot to answer for, and given how angry he must be about all of that, you can bet your bottom dollar the most powerful Avenger will be looking for revenge in Avengers 4. In Infinity War, Thor got his hands on an impressive new weapon in the form of Stormbreaker, which seemed like a good plan as it was definitely powerful enough to kill Thanos. However, his actions with his powerful new weapon were a little rash, and that's understandable, as he can't have been in a great state of mind. He rammed the weapon into Thanos' chest, then taunted the prune-chinned intergalactic despot while he writhed in pain. But as Thanos went on to state, he should have gone for the head, as the chest wound didn't quite kill him. So, the villain was still able to snap those fingers to trigger his cosmic cull, then use the Infinity Stones to teleport away and heal himself from his injuries. And he did it all quite literally right in front of the God of Thunder. Next time around, Thor will want to be more careful and calculated. He'll have time to think more carefully about how he goes about his revenge. Literally, he could have all the time in the world if, as expected, the heroes of the MCU learn how to manipulate and travel through time. And his plan could involve recruiting an army to attack the Mad Titan. There's been a theory since Avengers Infinity War was released of what Thor's mission will be in Avengers 4, thanks largely to a supposed plot leak, and apparently Captain Marvel will be helping him to do the recruiting. It makes sense that Thor would recruit an army, then lead them into battle. He's both a leader and a soldier above all else, after all, and it would definitely make Avengers 4 even more exciting than we're already expecting it to be if he does it. So, who could Thor recruit to his army? Well, with the fate of the universe at stake, old rivalries could be put aside, so the answer is potentially anybody. Of course, he'll rally the Avengers, both old and new, so Iron Man, Captain America, the Hulk, Black Widow, Hawkeye, Spider-Man, Doctor Strange, and Ant-Man will all be involved, as will the remaining Wakandans who fought so valiantly against Thanos' forces first time around. And having seen what Hela did in 2017's Thor Ragnarok when she led an army against him, one pretty awesome idea is that Thor will head to Valhalla to resurrect and recruit a horde of dead Asgardian soldiers. Seeing Thor leading an army of the undead would be incredible, right? Of course, in Infinity War, some of his allies from Thor Ragnarok were missing, and if they managed to escape the Asgardian refugee vessel before Thanos decimated its remaining passengers, Thor's army could also include the likes of Valkyrie, Korg, and Meek, and it's fair to say we'd all be more than happy to see those guys, especially the big blue Cronin voiced so wonderfully by Taika Waititi in Thor Ragnarok. On a related note, given that Thor now knows how much the Grandmaster loves to enslave powerful warriors to fight gladiatorial battles in his arena on Sakaar, the Avenger could return there to recruit his latest champion, and indeed the other enslaved fighters, to battle for the universe. Also, as we already touched upon, given what's at stake, Thor might even approach his enemies to lend a hand in the ultimate battle. They will all have lost friends, family, and allies when Thanos snapped his fingers after all. The God of Thunder knows exactly what the Frost Giants of Jotunheim are capable of, for example, having almost been overwhelmed by their army in the first Thor movie back in 2011. So there's every chance he could head back to the icy cold realm and request that his bitter enemies join him in the fight against Thanos and his evil allies. And what about the Marauders of Vanaheim, who Thor fought against in 2013's Thor: The Dark World? Or the Fire Demons of Muspelheim he faced off against in Thor: Ragnarok? They could all become temporary allies of the heroic cause if Thor tells them what's at stake. Essentially, the God of Thunder could travel through the Nine Realms, making allies of old foes. It's a really cool potential prospect, and the idea of Frost Giants, Fire Demons, and more fighting alongside each other is so incredibly exciting. You may also remember that when Thor visited Nidavellir, Eitri the Dwarf King proved himself to be quite the capable fighter, as he was able to manhandle Thor for a short time, and given that Thanos crippled his hands and killed all of his fellow dwarves, should Thor attempt to recruit the Weapons Master to his army, he'd surely be more than willing to step up, and wouldn't it be cool to see a character of his size tearing through the Mad Titan's hordes? This could also be a very cool way to introduce some new heroes to the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Beta Ray Bill, for example, could be introduced as a character Thor already knows in the MCU, and given that in the comics he's the rightful owner of Stormbreaker, Avengers 4 seems like the perfect opportunity to introduce the funky-faced hero to the MCU at large. In fact, his face was featured as one of the gladiatorial statues on Sakaar, which would certainly reinforce the idea of Thor returning there. There's also the potential to bring in characters from other mythological pantheons, as Norse mythology is just one source from which Marvel has taken inspiration to create godly characters like Thor and his Asgardian allies. If other pantheons exist in the MCU, and we already know one definitely does, you have to imagine Thor would know about them, and he could seek them out to ask them for help in the fight against Thanos. In Thor: Ragnarok, Ares was one of the characters whose face was carved into the Grandmaster's tower to form gladiatorial champions, so the Greek gods definitely exist in the franchise. That means other Olympian characters like Zeus, Hercules, Apollo, Athena, Pluto, Artemis, and Aphrodite should also be there. And can you imagine how freaking awesome it would be to bring them into the fight? Another very intriguing possibility is that Thor might be able to travel through time to recruit warriors from throughout history. That could potentially include recruiting the likes of his own father Odin, his own grandfather Bor, and countless other legendary Asgardians and Skyfathers, including Heimdall. So Thanos really could be in for a world of hurt. Of course, Loki could also be plucked from another point in time when he wasn't such a huge jerk in order to join the fight. Unless, of course, he didn't actually die in Infinity War, as some people have theorized. In which case, Thor might just touch base with him again in the present, and utilize his various skills to fight back against Thanos. Arguably the most exciting prospect, however, is the possibility Thor might get even more ambitious and look even higher for allies to recruit to his cause. He might be the one to bring Marvel's cosmic entities into the fight. Having grown up with Odin as a father, who taught Thor everything there is to know about the cosmos, the God of Thunder is bound to be familiar with the more powerful beings in the Marvel Cinematic Universe, and what they're capable of. Knowing what's at stake and how powerful Thanos is, it's not unrealistic to think that Thor might approach the likes of the Living Tribunal, Master Order, Lord Chaos, Love, Hate, Eternity, Infinity, Kronos, Uatu the Watcher, Epoch, the Stranger, Galactus, and the Celestials to join the fight, just like some of them did in the 1991 Infinity Gauntlet comic book arc. And that would undoubtedly make Avengers 4 a million times more interesting than it already is, and that's really saying something. Thor has made some dramatic and very welcome late entrances into the MCU to date. In Thor: The Dark World, he arrived in Vanaheim and brought a battle to an end. And in Avengers: Infinity War, he turned up in Wakanda with Stormbreaker, Groot, and Rabbit, or Rocket, you know, to give him his proper name. But he ultimately failed when it came to doing what he set out to do. If he was to arrive with that huge army in tow in Avengers 4, or even with an army one-third of that size, it would top anything he's ever done in the MCU previously by some distance. All things considered, if this theory turns out to be true, us fans could be in for one heck of a spectacle, especially if Captain Marvel recruits part of the army as well. Although we'll have to wait until her movie is released to speculate just who her recruits might be. There have been some amazing battles in the Marvel Cinematic Universe to date. The Battle of New York, in which the Avengers defended the Earth against the invading Chitauri army. The Battle at the Triskelion, in which Captain America, Black Widow, and Falcon fought on behalf of S.H.I.E.L.D. against Hydra's forces. The Battle of Xandar, in which the Guardians of the Galaxy and the Nova Corps fought against the Kree warlord Ronan and his army. The Battle of Sokovia, in which the Avengers went up against Ultron and his huge army of high-tech drones. And the Battle of Wakanda, in which countless heroes and warriors took on Thanos' children and the Outriders, for example. But this would undoubtedly top them all by quite a distance. Just imagine seeing Thanos with the Infinity Gauntlet, his Outriders, potentially the Chitauri, and whoever else the Mad Titan recruits to his side in Avengers 4, facing off against Thor and his fellow Avengers like Iron Man, Captain America and the Hulk, the Guardians of the Galaxy, the armies of Wakanda, an undead horde of Asgardian soldiers, an array of cosmic entities, Thor's father Odin and his grandfather Bor, Loki, Beta Ray, Bill, Valkyrie, Korg, Meek, the Olympian gods, frost giants, fire demons, marauders, plus Captain Marvel and her recruits. There's really never been a battle of that scale depicted in a superhero movie, or any movie for that matter, and it would be absolutely epic and totally awe-inspiring to witness, and Thor would have himself a much better group of Revengers than he did in Thor Ragnarok. We're drooling just thinking about it, but we're also struggling to imagine how Marvel could possibly top it going forward, although that would be for them to figure out, and for us to theorize about. What do you think of this theory? Is Thor likely to recruit an army in Avengers 4? And is that something you'd like to see? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Screen Rant for more great videos just like this one. Farewell, tiny pretty people of Midgard. Doth Mother know you spend so much time on YouTube?